Good morning, monkeys. Welcome to another installment of our RCT Classic series for iPad here at Coaster Monkey Studios. So this time we're going to jump on back over to our Alpine mining area. And we're going to build out, as requested by Joshua Fisher, YouTuber Joshua Fisher. Thanks so much for commenting on what type of ride you'd like to see here. You are definitely celebrated in helping us get this figured out. So yeah, we decided to build a river ride, river rapids for this particular area of the park. And I thought it came out pretty good. We had this huge mountain structure that we had built out. And the intention here was to create something that was both indoors and outdoors. It had a lot of twisty turny sections. Obviously some rapid areas. There's a waterfall area. So yeah, I kept it very eclectic, if you will. One thing you'll see here as I'm building this out is I definitely go back and forth a lot with the theming and kind of how I want it to feel. You know, there's this one portion where it goes through where it's very rocky, almost feels like you're going through canyons. And then you end up in this huge foresty area. You go past this little mining operation and you go up a lift hill and that brings you back around. So it's huge, a huge variety, or a lot of variation, excuse me, in what you're kind of experiencing as you're going through this particular ride. But yeah, so I think I put on here three separate lift hills for this. And again, it came out really well. I'm very pleased with the final edition here. Now, one thing you want to be mindful of as you're building this, especially if you're doing these longer drop sections, that you're giving a good amount of area for that ride vehicle to slow down. Now, as you'll see, going through the first sections, you know, I'll have a drop and then a straightaway, a drop and a straightaway, a drop and a straightaway. And what that does is that gives a very fast-paced ride and increases the excitement level of the ride while keeping good flow for the vehicle as it goes through. And again, you know, thinking about our queue line here and the exit, you know, I build this out and I think to myself, you know, I don't think this is going to work. So I changed this up a little bit here, and then I wound up changing it again later. So everything you're looking at now is just completely moot. But you know, trial and error, right? That's what this game is all about. You want to make sure that you're really going with the flow and kind of what feels good for you and whatnot. So here around this waterfall area, I tend to not like those waterfall pieces sticking out on their own. So I usually build some type of a rocky setup around it, a mountain or you know, crumbled up rocks like this. You know, think very, again, alpine-esque, think runaway mine train feeling from Walt Disney, you know. And again, we're hiding the trough and we're covering up the trough all the way around. So you really don't see the white part too much. And that's the intention. You want to build all the way around, give a nice clean look for the trough for the ride vehicle. Now for this portion, I was debating, should I keep it just as mountainside? Or should I make the rock portion continue? And I went forward with, you know, continuing with the rock portion. I felt like it was a really good look, and the rest of the ride itself there kind of goes through more of that alpine feel and not so much the rock quarry. There's a lot of rock work in this video, sorry guys. But you kind of get the point, right? So the next thing I decided to do is to come back around and use that mountain building tool that is an option within the terrain menu And I build up the mountain around the ride. This way I don't have to continue to lift up those individual pieces. And I think this turned out to be a huge benefit for me, because I was able to, whoops, see, you gotta be careful there. I was able to create a really good pathway that I enjoy much better than what I had before for the queue and for the exit path. Now there is a lot of open area on this mountain, and that's something I did intentionally, because as we build out the area next to this, which most likely is going to be Wild West, I'm thinking of having some type of roller coaster that's going to careen in and out of the woods on this side, so it goes in between both areas. Thinking very like California, like, you know, in the one state where you can go to the beach, ski, mountain climb, lay in a hot spring. I mean, they're just in one state, you can do so much, right? So that's the whole idea, going between this one coaster, going between these two areas, it's gonna have a really nice feel to it. I speak very much so to the Old West and you know, Calico ghost town or Calico mining town, that type of idea. I like this portion here as it goes down, and you can kind of see how those drops work, and it keeps the boat moving on a consistent basis. And again, you know, it's a long ride, so you want to make sure that your guests don't get bored. So you got to keep those boats moving at a pretty expeditious pace. And this is where I decide to open the ride. And this is something that I've been doing. I'm just opening up the rides as I go and building the scenery around it. I like to see the rides running with people on them. It's just something that I personally prefer. Yeah, I know quite a few people who, when they build out their parks, they'll wait until the entire area is finished to open it up to the customer, but or to the guest, but you know what? I'm like, whatever. Look at that, all those people, oh my goodness. See, this is what's great too. As your park gets in upwards of 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, even 6,000 guests, you've got to be mindful of that as you're playing, because all of those people are going to run towards this ride, and that entire area that you built a new ride, it's going to get inundated with your guests, and you're going to end up with a severe challenge of not only keeping the floor clean, making sure there's enough trash receptacles, making sure there's enough maintenance workers, making sure that there is enough security guards, because any benches you put down, any lampposts you put down, they're gonna get broken. So just being very mindful of that as well. All right, and here we are starting to build out the little mining facility that I created that the ride goes through here at the bottom. And this is also gonna be in part as our entryway as well. And what I did here, which I thought was pretty cool, was having, again, our entertainers kind of run through that. So this way, not only as your guests are walking past the ride, but when they're on the exit, along the exit, excuse me, of the ride, they're going to be able to see these entertainers as well. Now, when you're doing like mining buildings, one thing I think I should have mentioned at a different earlier time, you know, again, my aesthetic is very similar. A lot of my buildings do tend to look similar for the most part, but you want it to be a little bit more blocky when it comes to these mining slash logging buildings. And that's kind of what I went after here. And there's that pathway there for our entertainers. So again, kind of get to go in and out, weave in and out of the buildings, and they come out from behind, and there they are. And this is a good way to entice your guests to walk into the ride. And now again, I know it's a video game, but I think about this as being a real theme park, right? So when you're playing the game, you know, this is what I'm thinking about. When I'm walking past the ride and I see entertainers coercing me to go into a ride, I'm like, oh, I need to check this out. This is something different, right? Thank you. See, now, again, when it comes to these stock pieces as well, like they're cool and all, but there are so few of them that the theming gets stagnant and repetitious, in my opinion. So that's why I try to do as many of my own buildings as possible. Look at how awesome that ride looks going down that canyon. Oh, so cool. So I'm putting it on Joshua Fisher. He asked us to choose this ride for the mountainside. This was his suggestion. So I'm putting it up to Joshua Fisher. What do you want to name this ride? All right, Mr. Joshua Fisher, you let us know. Now, one thing I started doing here, which I thought was pretty cool, is I thought that the cap of these lift hills would be really cool to go through another mining building, fill it with all of this, you know, different theming stuff, and then build a building on top of it. Now, when you're doing a forest area, you're gonna see I have a lot of trees that are exactly the same. And after I did it, I realized, you know what, it looked a little repetitious and redundant. So what you wanna do is you wanna make sure that you're using different types of trees for your forest areas if you are doing an abundance of, you know, trees and foliage and whatnot. And it's something I'm probably gonna go back and change and layer in a vast amount of different types of trees to give it more variety so it doesn't look so repetitive. You see how it starts to become redundant, right? Oh, look, see the pathway there has changed. I should have pointed that out earlier. I did that off camera. I did make an adjustment to that pathway. And there is a ton of tree work here. And this is, you know, this is something that does get a little redundant, but you know, it's a necessary evil, right? Especially if you're starting from a blank slate for your park, and it's kind of what we went after. Now, again, going with the whole idea of increasing that excitement rating of the ride, you know, I did layer in quite a few things here, different buildings to walk through as you're going through the queue. There's a nice little barrier there to keep people from walking out. And then from this point on, I kind of build the queue through all these different buildings to walk through. So this way there's not only shade, but it also gives a little, you know, feeling of different, right? And then I think I come back, I'm pretty sure I come back in a little bit and I layer in TVs for the queue line. I'm going to go back and do TVs for all of the queue lines for all the major rides as well that have longer lengths so our guests don't get bored and frustrated with the amount of time it takes for the ride to move through its people, right? It's so funny. I actually filmed this a week and a half ago now. And now I'm just doing the commentation for it this morning. And it's like, I don't remember exactly what I did. So bear with me if I stumble my way through a little bit. Yeah, this is cool here. So I left the station building as is and just embellished upon it, as you can see there. I really like that long straight building. I don't know what it was about it. It kept the vibe simple. It wasn't too overdone. And then I layered in just more scenery buildings around here. Like this would be maybe a mechanism house with a tower. So the tower can overlook and see, you know, the boats that are coming into the station versus going out of the station. Who knows what this is, right? The lifeguard station. Oh my God, it's so repetitious. I'm gonna have to go back and delete all these trees and put in other ones. It's just too much. Yeah. But again, it's all trial and error, right? And, you know, you do something, you like it, you move forward with it, and hey, who you are today may not be who you were yesterday, right? So you might decide to change your decisions. And it's quite normal. You know, it happens all the time when building out these different scenarios and whatnot. Here I get a little bit lazy in building buildings. I'm just getting so bored of building buildings. Excuse me. You know, it's funny if you think about it, really, I only have two roller coasters so far in this whole park. And we're already on episode, what, 9? Going on episode 10? And we only have two roller coasters. You know, just to give you an idea of like how much work goes into building out these dramatic scenery and theming and themed areas, right? It's a lot of work. Now you see all the repetitious trees, like I was saying earlier, I'm definitely gonna have a ride that's gonna, you know, hop in and out and in between these little forested areas up and over our River Rapids ride. So not only will that give the River Rapid ride an increase in its excitement level, but what it'll also do is give an increase to the roller coaster that we build through here. What about kind of coaster I wanna build next? For our Wild West area. Obviously, your first go-to is, oh, you need a Woody. But I think of like Cedar Point with Maverick, with that fantastic intimate launch coaster, where you necessarily don't need a wooden coaster for a Wild West area. You know, that's something that I think I definitely want to go forward with. Maybe not an intimate, maybe a Giga, maybe an Infinity coaster, Intamin Infinity coaster. Maybe a Premier launch coaster is a possibility as well. You know, a number of options, but I want to keep the options open for that one because I want to think outside of the box for that weenie ride for the Wild West area. All right, and we're just finishing up some buildings here that I throw in just across from our shop towers here, just to give a little bit more depth in the scenery. And I think I'm gonna come back and throw some souvenir stalls inside of that building there and the building outside of the River Rapids now that I think about it. I love the random wagons as well. Super fun. Now, being that this side of the park kind of goes into the western area there, what I decided to do was go into the dirt path and start building out a cave monster ride. So that's what this is here, the giant spider. And I think of Lord of the Rings when I think of the giant spider in the cave, right? But that's what we're going to do here. We're going to build up just some rock around it, very similar to how we did around the River Rapids ride there. And this will be the cave monster ride. I think I even named it Cave Monster. But again, you kind of get the idea of how that rock work works and how it's built up around. It gives a really, really clear understanding of kind of what's going on there. So again, even when we're lining up the edge of the walkway there, I love these little fences too. I want all of the walkways in the park get some sort of an edge. And that's definitely the idea we want to go forward here with every part of the park, right? Here goes some more trees. And then again, it's so repetitious. I'm gonna have to change that. I know I said that already, but it's just driving me nuts now as I see it. How lazy. All right, so here we are wrapping up the end of the video, just to give you an idea of, again, to say thank you to Mr. Joshua Fisher for naming our wooden coaster. We're gonna name it the Iron Horse. So thank you again, Mr. Joshua Fisher, and don't forget, you gotta name our River Rapids. I'm putting it on you, my friend. All right, guys, that's the end of our video today. Catch us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Reddit, Coaster Monkey Studios. I want to thank you again. Hope everybody's safe at home. And we'll all get through this at some point, right? Enjoy your day, guys. Chat with you soon.